Hello kids, and welcome to your daily morning podcast from 7:30 to 8:20 a.m. where we talk about entertainment and S. This is your host, DJ Mambo, and this is the Mambo Show.
Hello boys, how you all doing? And yeah, welcome to podcast number 4. This is Friday the 13th of November, and welcome to the show. So today I want to talk about a topic that is personal to me and fun to all teenagers. It's a difficult part of our lives, again, as teenagers, and that is love. Love, love, love. Let me tell you a bit about what love is. Love is the basic element of a teenager's life. It is what puts a boy and a girl together. And love can be tough. And I know that because of the many stories of divorces, marriages, divorces, abuse, teenagers getting crushed. Because, of course, it's understandable for teenagers to have a crush on someone. You go to a school, and within like 2 days, you find a girl of your interest, and you have a crush. And obviously, again, love can be tough because you don't know how to tell to that. You want to say to that girl, "Oh, I have a crush on you," but unlike all teenagers, some teenagers, you can't really, because one, that girl has friends, and it might seem, but for a teenager boy, it might seem humiliating, and even for girls as well, other way around, you want to tell a boy of a crush on him, but you just can't, and that's understandable. Yes, I have travels with love. I'm talking about this topic today because I am a bit of a ladies man. I like charming the ladies, as I've done since, 2015, 16. It's been a rocky journey. Yeah, I've charmed and annoyed girls very much. I've been accepted and rejected. Yes, I have been rejected. Rejection is not nice for anyone. For girls or boys, it is not nice for anyone. Sorry, it's cars. Yeah, again, rejection is unpleasant for anyone. It kind of breaks your heart. I have a question. I have a question to you. Do you want to be boyfriend and girlfriend? And the girl's like, "Sorry, mate, but I don't really like you that way, so I'm gonna have to break up with you, or I can't do this." Or you start dating, and then 2 days later you're like, "Oh," the girl's like, "Oh, sorry, we can't do this anymore. Yeah, I gotta go." And then just zoom out. It can happen on the date as well. On the date, as in not date, as in day to day, but the date, as in the restaurant or place you go into. Yeah, it can happen. And it's happened to me. Yeah, and but sometimes, and that's what I come to talk to you about today. Sometimes that girl can reject you for many reasons. Financial problems, children, child support, you get married, the woman gets pregnant, you have a baby, let's name him Marcus or Lily, and child is young and no life support. Child support. Yeah, you have problems with child support. And it can be hard for a man and a woman to go through that, Child goes from one house to another. Mom looks after one child. You know, one child goes, lives with the dad, the next day lives with the mom. It happens, and it is not nice for anyone. But there's another reason, and it's pretty serious, and I've heard many stories about it. Women can divorce or break up with men because of abuse. Yeah. Abuse, rape, abuse, rape, sexual assault, murder. You know, if a woman is married to a man who is a convicted criminal for murder, then she obviously doesn't want to be with him. And that's obvious. And we've heard many, many stories about men being abusive to women, and it's not good. The most recent one right now, and it's the one I'm bringing into this podcast today, is the what's it called? Johnny Depp and Amber Heard case. Yeah, we've all heard of that. So basically what happened was Amber Heard accused Johnny of being a wife beater. I said again, wife beater. He apparently abused her many times, and now Amber's going to court to report it. The court tried to take, I don't know how many months, but the jury finally comes to a verdict. And after months and years of trialing, the judge says, the judge counts Johnny Depp as guilty. Yes, Johnny Depp has been found guilty of abuse, and so his career is effed. Amber Heard, that's the last time I heard, Amber Heard was celebrating drinks with her family. Like, yay, drinks, yay. Johnny's in prison. Well, not in prison, but Johnny's done for. Just celebrating champagne with her family. And Johnny Depp's just sat there like, oh no, I'm effed. Yep, Johnny Depp's career is over. But the thing is, Johnny Depp didn't, the truth was, Johnny Depp did not beat Amber Heard at all. In fact, the whole story was a complete lie. The truth is, Amber had abused Johnny. Many videotapes and recordings of her being abusive to him, verbally, emotionally, physically, all forms. And apparently the judge is sexist. He sided with her because she's a woman. Yeah. The judge is one sexist little bag. One sexist little S bag. And so is Amber. So now, speaking of which, the new Aquaman 2 is coming in 2022, and Amber's gonna be in it as Mera, Aquaman's girlfriend or wife. And fans are calling for her removal. Yeah, she's the fans want Amber removed. They hate her now for what she's done. Well, for her, and the judge is done. And I felt kind of bad for Johnny. I kind of watch Pirates of the Caribbean. Yeah, and I've seen Johnny as Jack Sparrow, and he's a pretty good performance. I don't really watch Johnny Depp films at all. I don't even watch the guy, but I feel sorry for him. Last Jack Sparrow is going to be his only film character, to be fair. Yeah, it's the last movie you're ever going to see him in, so I feel bad for him. Anyway, we're moving off topic here. Yeah. The whole point was that love can be difficult for man and a woman. In the case of Johnny Depp and Amber Heard, Johnny's career ended because Amber abused him And now she just puts lemon to it. So you abuse someone of all forms, and then when it comes to court, you blame the other person. So, yeah, so Johnny Depp is done for now. You won't be seeing him in any films ever again, that's for sure. And anyway, the whole point of that was that, yeah, love can be difficult. So anyway, and that's why I've come to talk to you today about advice. I want to tell you a little personal story of my own. Yeah, again, I've been rejected by a bunch of girls, because apparently I'm a weirdo to them, and I'm really not. And to be fair, that's not really a condition, but I have this thing where, let's say I talk to a girl, and she goes, oh, hello, or she says hello, but then giggling, and then giggles behind her phone when I leave. Yes, it happens, and I don't like it at all. Let's say I smile. What am I saying? Let's say I tried saying hello to her, and she just blatantly ignores me. Like, what the F? I say hello to a girl, and she just walks past, and I'm right next to her. You know how that makes me feel? Heartbroken. And mind you, that's a girl I like. So, imagine, I take her along and she gives me some dirty looking, dirty flipping look. And I have this thing where I'm a bit of a simp, as we call it nowadays. A simp. I'll do anything to regain that girl's friendship. Regain our friendship, even if I don't know the flipping girl. I don't know the flipping girl, but yeah, I tend to be a bit of a simp. I'm not really, but apparently that's what people call me, and I don't like it at all. Yes, let me tell you about a bit of a simp. A simp is someone who would do anything for a girl that I don't even know. You know, let's say you have a girl there. They're saying hello, and you know, she gives some dirty looks, or she hates you. You turn into a simp, and you like do anything to regain the friendship or love that you had or you once had. And yeah, I've got some pretty harsh comments calling me a simp. One time, it was Debbie Ryan's birthday. I can't remember which day. And so I posted so it's wet, so. I'm gonna do. I don't damage my friends. So. Yeah. So what happened once was I posted a picture of Debbie Ryan on her birthday. No, Debbie, the Jersey star. I posted a picture of her saying happy birthday. Please say happy birthday to her. And the comments I got were pretty harsh. I had people calling me a simp. A simp for Debbie Ryan, because she's this big celebrity, right? Massive celebrity. Sorry boys, it was raining, so I had to take shots, but I'm back now. So, and what were we talking about? Debbie Ryan. So yeah, I posted a picture of Debbie Ryan on my Instagram because it was her birthday, and I was very proud of it. Extremely proud. You know, celebrating my childhood celebrity crush on her birthday. And 1 hour later, I get a comment saying, drum roll please, you're a simp. Yes, I'm a simp. I'm a simp. I don't know what I was a simp. I'm a simp for celebrating my childhood crush's birthday. And to be fair, I don't know what I was a simp for. Celebrating my celebrity crush's birthday itself, the birthday itself, or the fact I posted it on Instagram. I don't know, probably both, but we'll see. Anyway, let me on a, don't really have long with me left, but I'll make this quick. So, I just want to talk about something quick. Abuse, yes, abuse. We covered abuse. that it's not pleasant, it affects mental health, and you know, and it can get you in massive trouble. And the thing is, the sex system is that a man abuses a woman. A woman abuses a man. Is defended. It goes off a free woman because, you know, women are better than boys, apparently, according to Amber Heard. You know, I was doing it in self-defense, and you let them go. Really? Men abuse a woman. They try the same thing. They're off to jail. It's so unfair, the system now, in 2020. So flipping unfair. Anyway, I also want to cover something. Need something to talk about. You know, like again, we covered abuse. And, what I want to talk about is how abusing a woman abusing a man and how that affects the man versus a man abusing a woman and how that affects the woman. So let's start with the man first. You're in a relationship, you're in a marriage, a couple, and all of a sudden, like, the woman starts being abusive. The man hitting, beating the man, like Amber did to Johnny. And it can affect the man kind of badly because it decreases their low self-esteem. It decreases their self-esteem emotionally, you know. Yeah, you're not confident enough to talk to a girl, which kind of destroys the chances of ever finding love again. You know, and I learned that from experience because I've been rejection and I've actually kind of been hit. Have I been slapped by a girl? I believe so. So not in abuse jail kind of way, but this is a normal teenage slap on the face, you know. And it's kind of affected me because it destroys my. Give up. It normally would destroy a man's self-esteem, but it does really to me, because, I'm still confident, I'm still going, and that's why men can't speak up. Men can't speak up, as people are saying, and stuff, because of Johnny Depp and Amber Heard, that men can't speak up because of what's happened. A woman hits a man. Man goes to court, tries to defend himself, and the judge apparently doesn't give a damn. He's sexist and brands the woman as the victim. And therefore the man goes off to jail or has his career effed up. And it's not nice. I don't like it. It's not good. At all. The woman should be held accountable for her actions. And not to play victim when you're the one hitting the man. So it's not good. But the woman, a man hitting a woman is extremely, it's more serious because, again, self-esteem, it can decrease your, like, self-esteem. Like, you don't trust boys. It just makes you not trust boys. Even your best friend. You get abused by a man. But a man or boy, your boyfriend. And like, you don't know who to trust anymore. And you just turn to your own sex because you don't know what boys will do to you. According to that situation, you can't trust the same sex anymore. You have to go to another one. You have to go to a boy or girl. You know, opposite sex is. It's a common thing that happened. And another thing, self-harming. Yes, we've heard many stories of self-harming because of boyfriends or one of the most disturbing cases, coming on live stream. Let's say live streaming a game or just live streaming yourself. Then you're coming with bruises. It reduces your confidence. If you come with black eye, sores everywhere, or when your viewers ask you, oh, oh, what happened? The ghost is like, nothing happened. Smiling, just trying to keep the spirits up like nothing ever happened, when you can clearly see something has happened to you. And that is very serious. It's happened before. It's kind of horrific. And another thing is self-harming. Yes, again, we've heard many stories of self-harming because of boyfriends, abuse, you know. I don't know about suicide, but I definitely know about self-harming. Ming. It just destroys your chances of not even love, but life. Imagine going to work and finding a man next to you. Like, you just don't want to sit next to him, not because you hate him, because you don't trust him. No, and self-harming. Self is a serious thing in today's society. Suicide. And it affects, it kind of affects the whole globe. It affects the whole globe in a way. I just want to touch upon that. That it's serious. It's a seriousness and the impact abuse can have on anyone, because it can have a bunch of impacts and none of them end well. So I was gonna touch it upon that. So here's some we don't have long with me left. I'm gonna have to wrap this up now, so I'm just gonna give you some quick top tips to make sure you have a sustainable relationship and you don't end up having the problems I discussed earlier in this podcast. So top tip number one: always treat the woman like a queen. Yes, since women are vulnerable to abuse and stuff, abuse and hatred, you as a man might want to treat your woman like a queen. Like a queen, like in the morning, make her a cup of tea or give her flowers or just, you know. It doesn't have to be big. Let's bring Kim Kardashian to meet. Just sign an autograph for her. Not even that. It is something very small. Something very, very small. Another thing, take her out. Yes, take her out. By the way, sorry, about the queen thing. You won't treat her like a queen, because once you're horrible to her, she'll break up with you. And trust me, like me, it's very hard to get her back. You'll probably never get her back again. Never again. Never, you'll never. Never again. Never, either that or it'll take years to get her back. And when you do, or just be like best friend, or to just make up with you again. Like, come on. Like, you want to make your relationship great. So yeah, respect the girl. Number two. Yeah, that was number one. Number two. Take her out. You know, women nowadays, they like to go out to shops. Eat restaurant, go to restaurants, go to places, eat food, you know. They want you to, so take her out. And I know that from experience, because the Instagram story, I took my friend Rachel out to Valentine's Day. And Valentine's Day, yeah, that's another thing I forgot to tell. Valentine's Day is the day for love, the day where you have to treat your girlfriend like a proper queen. Valentine's, you cannot screw your relationship on Valentine's, because it will not end well. And you're about taking out take her out, make sure you treat her like, you know, sorry, take her out, pay for her dinner, you know, say compliments about her, you know, just don't harass her. And that's gonna be the next point. Don't harass her, but just, you know, give her the respect she deserves. You know, she's like a true man. Yeah, anyway, Valentine's Day, I took her out to Valentine's. We had a great time, you know, bowling. And then we ate like this little kiddie basket full of chips and burgers. But we still had a good time. And then I made her cry, in a good way. I proposed to her. No, okay, I didn't propose, that's what I'm saying. I didn't propose, as in, tell her to marry me. But what I did do is, I was even scored that day. So I wanted to give her like a little card and chocolates and teddies to...
Are you doing a TikTok?
I proposed to her. I gave her a card. I read it out to her. The video's on my IGTV on Instagram. And once again, my Instagram is djhardrxx21. Yes, again, at DJ, all lowercase, djhardrxx21. Yeah, I used to be saying that every podcast. Anyway, yeah, so it's on my ITV TV story. I read it out to her, I gave her the presents, the chocolate, I gave her like a Valentine's teddy. And yeah, she had an amazing time. And I guess she'll remember that for the rest of her life. Ladies man style. Yes, let's go. Okay. Yeah, so take her out. And the last point before I go, privacy. Remember when I discussed before that abuse and you know, hatred. If the woman's feeling down and just upset, just know it's not because of you, unless you do something to her. It just might be because something happened at work, or she got fired, or I don't know, just something hit her, or she's just having a bad day. So yeah, privacy. Make sure you give her all the time she needs. Please don't harass her, because that can lead to problems. And if you want to comfort her, give her a compliment, you know? Comfort her. Treat her like the woman she deserves, you know? Be with her. All the time, you know? Don't control her, obviously. Don't control the things she does, because that can lead to jail. But, you know, comfort her. Yeah. So just treat her like the... Sorry if I'm repeating the same stuff over and over again. Sorry about that. Yeah, just give her the respect she deserves. She's like the queen she is. And yeah, there are many more tips, but let's just stick with those three. I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to close up now. So, because it's almost 8:20, 2 minutes to 8, it's 2 to 8:20. So, yeah, I'm gonna have to close up. I just wanna thank you all for joining in today. Join us next Monday for the Nostalgia podcast, where we talk about childhood memories and, you know, the good moments of our lives before 2020. Okay. Yeah. I was going to do that today, but something happened, so it's been moved to Monday. And yeah, catch us on Monday for that Nostalgia podcast. Guess that will be Monday the 16th. Yeah, Monday 16th November 2020. Well, it's just next Monday, so yeah. Tune in for that. Thank you for joining the Mambo Podcast Show. Remember, we are here from 7:30 to 8:20, where we talk about entertainment and S. This is your host, Diallo, and this is the Mambo Show. Roll
like it's whatever, it's whatever, it's whatever. You let that go like it's whatever, it's whatever, it's whatever. Bait me roll like it's whatever, it's whatever, it's whatever. It's whatever, it's whatever, it's whatever.
Gotta take the time to cut them off, I need help. I know how to make the girl go crazy. When you treat her like you're number one.